Shock, Obama hid 470,000 documents from bin Laden raid in order to win 2012 election. The most transparent administration in U.S. history. The Obama administration hid almost 500,000 documents seized from the bin Laden raid in order to ensure Obama's re-election in 2012. The Weekly Standard revealed in a very powerful piece written by Stephen Hayes, how the Obama administration hid hundreds of thousands of documents from the bin Laden raid in order to make it look like Aqua had been defeated following bin Laden's death. Until now, only 571 documents from this raid were available to the public. Why would ADNI think it could get away with such an aggressive lie? Why would officials there believe that they wouldn't be asked to reconcile the fact that they were releasing just 571 documents with the repeated pronouncements that the Abbottabad collection was the largest haul of terrorist intelligence ever? The answer, the self-proclaimed most transparent administration in history had spent more than 5 years misleading the American people about the threat from Al-Qaeda and its offshoots and had paid very little price for having done so. Republicans volubly disputed the president's more laughable claims the attack on the Benghazi compound was just a protest gone bad, Al-Qaeda was on the run, ISIS was the terrorist junior varsity, but the establishment media, certain that Obama's predecessor had consistently exaggerated the threat, showed little interest in challenging Obama or the intelligence agencies that often supported his spurious case. Journalists knew the Obama administration was sitting on a huge document haul. Editor of the Weekly Standard Stephen Hayes pointed out, a senior military intelligence official who briefed reporters at the Pentagon on May 7, 2011, said, "As a result of the raid, we've acquired the single largest collection of senior terrorist materials ever." Hayes continued. In the spring of 2012, with the Republican presidential primaries nearing an end and shortly before the first anniversary of the successful raid on bin Laden's compound, Obama's National Security Council handpicked 17 documents to be provided to the Combating Terrorism Center at West Point for analysis. The West Point documents were shared with Obama-friendly journalists. Their conclusion was the only one possible, given the documents they were provided. At the time of his death, Osama bin Laden was frustrated and isolated, a relatively powerless leader of a dying organization. In the summer and fall of 2012, Obama would use this theme as the main national security rationale for his re-election. Al-Qaeda was alternately on the run or decimated or on the path to defeat. Just days before the 2012 presidential election, Obama gloated over the military's successes fighting terrorists, declaring the Iraq war is over and bragged about the war in Afghanistan winding down. Obama was a true wartime president and hero to all Americans, according to the media sycophants. Obama repeated this over and over again until Election Day in 2012. And what do these newly released bin Laden documents reveal? Hayes writes. In a manner of speaking, Barack Obama wanted what Al-Qaeda already had, a mutually beneficial partnership with Tehran. Revealing to the American people the truth about Osama bin Laden's cozy working relationship with the Iranian government might have fatally undermined that diplomatic quest, just as the ongoing vitality of Al-Qaeda, amply testified to in the bin Laden documents, would have contradicted Obama's proud claims in 2012 that Al-Qaeda was on the run. So Obama, with the eager cooperation of some in the intelligence community, bottled up the bin Laden documents and ran out the clock. There you have it. Obama ran out the clock on the release of these documents so he can perpetuate the lie that various terrorist factions were no longer a threat in order to get re-elected.